decision. Had to go to the state council, you know, the city council, crap, that's the same way. But I know that we're quite fast, state charter. I'd be all for it. If that's kind of where this is going.
So this body could at some point, if they wish, make a recommendation of the city council to that effect. But the DPW,
I'll buy it.
DPW is resistant to the idea at this point, I think the public would be as well. But I'm working on it.
I think that definitely surprised me too, I think that was nice, but I don't think it did.
And it just makes people aware that they, that there might be bikes or someone across, and that's all we want to do on Main Street.
Yeah, and so I don't know why they're so resistant to it, because they don't have to do it, they're resistant to the bike rack, but they don't look to think of it.
Well, not to have to defend the DPW director in his decision-making process, but it's partially because of when you're pushing snow, it's one more object on the road.
No, that's why I'll take it out before the snow can even fly.
Yeah.
November 1, you pick them up.
Yeah, the signs that you're proposing in the middle of the road would be hit by cars on a constant basis.
But then I'll just buy new ones, they can't get hurt, it is flat down.
Well, so there's also liability of the city of somebody damaging somebody's car, and, you know, then somebody has to run out to the road and pick it up and traffic.
They hit a yield sign.
Saying, it's not so simple.
They have those, it's a liability as well.
In any case, it's a little bit more complicated than foot monitor.
Trustee, I'm sorry, Jerry. I have a question for all of you folks. Laura, we all know that is an event, and at least a lot of the city can start putting together marijuana shops for everyone calling in downtown. But we need to decide, if we're putting together ordinances, where do we want to see them? Where do we not want to see them? So, just a few folks, businessmen in the downtown, have any ideas?
I've been to a lot of cities that have allowed them, and some that are adjacent, like Sacramento, Davis, all through California. If they're done correctly, there's no trouble. Just don't put them by churches or schools.
Small town, that's what we're looking at, small town, and that's what we're looking at. And our laws, the thing that the state has written, are disciplined. They should be, you know, because it's kind of government authority. We can put them in the downtown area, and we increase foot traffic to the other businesses.
There is a stigma from what marijuana used to be, but the thing is, when you go to Sacramento, there's not a bunch of dangerous individuals hanging around, they're professionals that are coming in, and then they're spending money.
There it is.
And they're going to drop $500 to $800 just to go buy some stuff. And they stay with the money to go there.
But that's where we're in the process of writing an ordinance to this stuff, to just do that, you know. How many shops do you want to see on Main Street?
You don't want more than two. Because then it becomes two over balance. Just like we don't need another pizza shop.
Well, that's where we're wrestling with the fact of, how many licenses do we allow here in the city of Charleston? How many do we keep on border in downtown? It won't be allowed in residential. It won't be allowed any 1,000 feet from a school.
That's gotta be allowed from school to churches.
There's a school over here, there's a school over here, but it's a narrow band, I think. So that's where we're wrapping the.
We're bringing some big money and some big development out here. Like brand new building, a brand new facade, that whole block where it's like, is it right there? If it's black others.
The retail portion of our producer program, the manufacturing process, which should be able to use for industrial area.
This would be directly shared sale.
Yeah, that's all they do is raise up retail areas. What they usually do is they have an unarmed security guy outside. They have an unarmed security guy inside, and they have an armed guy deep inside. But they're all in radio communications, and they only allow so many people in the store. They take every ID
question is, if we allow it downtown and allow it in the HC district up by McDonald's, will the marijuana businesses up at McDonald's kill the marijuana businesses downtown?
Yeah, I would put it downtown. It's a boutique thing, and you want that money coming downtown. But out there, they have all the traffic anyway. It's like the, what's happening in America is all of, sorry about that, all of the downtown areas are dying because new highways set up. People get off the freeway, they go to KFC, they don't come to the Redwood, they don't come to the downtown.
So it sounds like the DDA and the chamber should be advocating for a position.
I would say anywhere in downtown. I wouldn't put it out by the freeway. I would bring the people
that are spending, they have
what? All the money in their pockets coming in.
That's where we're at. We want the chamber and then to say, okay, this is where we would like to see them, so the future profit.
Downtown is where I'd like to see them, because any of them that put in a store in that, you'd have the money to do these projects for them.
Absolutely. That's what we're looking at.
So you're asking, do we want to move this to the...
Well, basically, that's what I'm saying. We want it in the downtown, or we want it on 18. We want it in the mixed use.
We want to be the first on the ball. We don't want to have Rockford be Cedar Springs at it. Because the thing is if they do, then no one's going to come. If they drag their feet and they bring it here, we're going to get more traffic. We're going to go to the city.
That's what we're working on, but just so you business people are aware, we've been dealing with this for 2 years. And it's coming now, the state finally released the rules. So now we have to put our ordinances together to fit our little town, not the big city. So, and that's where I hear the downtown business, DDA here, is saying we want to have that.
If you really have the weekend portion of the structure, not everybody,
that will all the city. We're only going to get it, so still no making outside this
stuff. It's really true. City Portland had a public forum, and it's all nice. It didn't have one up at the library, you don't have to come to public. So we've got, you know, the city passed it by 54% in town. 58 in town, still. We've got a big majority there that don't want
it. I think a lot of it, though, is people, it's the stigma. People can't venture to the deal where it's become legal. And you go out west, you go to Colorado, you go to California.
The government has criminalized it for years, and now it's not.
There's the schools have a surplus of money, their roads are all beautiful and new. There's money.
But there's problems that come with it. And that's where it's trying to.
I want to say one thing. He's right.
Yeah.
Okay, it's just, and I go right all the way back to the race car. Yeah. We didn't drag our feet. We were forced to do it by so much.
Yeah.
And that cost the city millions and millions of dollars.
Yeah.
And you know it. You probably don't because I was really in the league.
Same with mine.
Because we drag our, not necessarily we drag our feet. You know, it was a problem.
And, you know, we're growing community. We need to make the council, and it's going to start with the planning commission to develop the ordinance, and then Mr. Womack. But we're trying to pull together all the outlying communities, what their ordinances are, to condense it down to, okay, what's going to work for Cedar? That's my, what's going to work for Cedar? I don't care about Colorado or another place.
Right.
What's going to work for Cedar?
And that's where Davis, the ones in Davis, they're the same. Yeah, they're a little bit bigger than Cedar Springs, but it's a small little boutique walkable.
Davis?
It's right next door to Sacramento. So, UC Davis is there.
I'm sorry, I was thinking Davis, Michigan. I'm like,
No. It's flying to Sacramento. It's 15 minutes drive away.
Yeah, Portland has had a big meeting. And
just putting it small and built in Oregon.
That's all I have.
It's hard to store Davis now.
Well, in any case, the city will be attempting to hold a public forum probably in October. So it'd be nice to hear from the DDA and the chamber of their positions.
Do you have a deadline for this year?
You have applicants standing in front of it.
So the state is just now issuing their licenses.
Yeah.
I suspect you won't see a single legal sale in the state of Michigan until February or March.
And so we have the space available.
Well, if somebody's got $327,000.
We're working through that now.
So if anybody would like to discuss marijuana after the meeting, I'd be happy to talk.
Okay, so, thank you, everybody, for arriving and giving your input.
I'll go along with this, with talking with everybody, but I do have a question, and I'm finding a copy here, actually. And every, I, 2, 3, 4 times a day, I go through the leadership to the manager. And this morning, I had to, after the meeting, I thought, I want to go out and take those funds, go on the bus, and decide. And, but I don't know, I can't believe the city would do that.
So what happened was DTE was fixing a gas leak?
Yeah, that was, they needed a patch.
And so they fixed it, they patched it, they were supposed to leave it for 7 days to cure. They then put their cones out and disappeared.
Yeah.
So when I came in this morning, I ordered the DPW director to go pick up their cones for them. So I think you just shoved them into the grass on the side of the road.
What I was going to do was take my cans a little quick.
We were hoping that they would come clean up their own ass.
I sent them on Monday. Well, if you don't care, I need to. No, it's a shame that they were leaving like that.
They don't care.
But you're on, and I was still thinking.
Well, when they get back down, and you got the cone, and they can drive it across the country, you know, there were cones there.
Yeah, it looked down the road.
Anyway, it's our can. Thank you.
Thank you.
But why would that happen? 7 days during?
Yeah. Close to
30. And then they could have just put it right, they could have been dead, they still could have been left, they could have been dropped the street, and we had. Okay. Your turn.
Update and the band has been working on this, working it guts out. Very happy to do it for our city. We're down to once a week meetings and tightening up all the details. And I think that's going to be a wonderful time, as usual.
Isn't that all the years you've been here?
Oh, absolutely.
We can get one on the front of the floor. Dr. Neal, my guys are talking about when to vote. I'm trying to figure out each of them.
Okay, well, you will come down to office. We've got 2 meetings in the office after, but pretty soon we'll be open. A lot of folks coming from all over the world, different needs, and people come from different parts of the country, they have family meetings, they have class meetings. This is the latest.
I do like doing the City Hall and DPW and that included because I actually like to do something that you left me out. There are job descriptions, all right? Normal hour description, basically, you know what? You have a lot of good people in this community, really good organizations. They spend the volunteer hours and they take a lot of flack for people in the public that don't necessarily know what's going on because they can't get involved. So I just want to give kudos to everybody that's come in there, stay with it, stay the course. After the grass and them up there around the amphitheater, just going to lay the amphitheater, that shit falls up for the use of that. The process of that may turn over to the city, which I'm not sure.
I talked to the city attorney today about that, but it's not a complicated process, it's just he's been sure he doesn't.
Right. I'm going to take a look at the motion for
adjournment. Motion to adjourn.
Except for the one guy. discussion here. Let's talk about the land. Just to have a general idea of what